Massacred Indians, but I was with the Indians always, you know. And then, you know, then you know, things like I like names. Like, for instance, there's a guy, a baseball player, Duke Snyder. I just like that name. So I liked him. He's like the New York Giants. The New York Giants is a play that was called Polo Grounds. But up in actually it's in Harlem. You know, Polo Grounds, well, at least when I was growing up, I was very young then, but you could go to the projects that was across, it's called projects, and look into and see the game. In fact, when they used to have the Polo Grounds, they had the thing called Cooligan's Bluff, for instance, this is important, when the Giants left New York, see the Brooklyn Dodgers, but they arrived from the Brooklyn, left New York too. When they both left New York, then a new team was created called the Mets. And the Mets took the Giants' colors and the Brooklyn Dodgers' colors. You know, Jackson and Brooklyn Dodgers. And they were so rough for their own colors. Now, here's the important part. I'm a Mets fan. Now, you say, but the Mets did. Well, they sort of started in, well, not the Polo Grounds, they started in Shea Stadium in Queens. They said, but you were a Bronx boy. Aren't you supposed to be with the Yankees? Well, truth be told, my first job was with the New York Giants, when they were playing at Yankee Stadium then, you know, so that's my football team. But baseball, the first ticket I bought to a game was to the New York Mets in Shea Stadium, so I'm a Mets fan. Guess what's happening now? Right now, the World Series is on, and the Mets are in the World Series. My team! What's interesting about the teams I choose, I mean, like, a lot of times people don't pay attention to them, then they have these low years, but then when they come back spectacularly. Now, one of the things when I was with the Mets, or playing, you know, when I went to see the Mets, they had, a name. There was a guy, I think it was a catcher, called Choo Choo Coleman. You like that name? Come on, Choo Choo Coleman. That's a good name, you know? Well, I'm saying all this stuff because I was watching, I saw this little clip of Trevor Noah, and he asked him about what's his team, whatever happened. He says, I never understand about this team thing. Anybody wants to do a team? He just follows players. Like in rugby, I like rugby. But when I first came to South Africa, there was this guy, I think he was playing for, what was he playing for? The Bulls? The Blue Bulls? He was playing for, maybe no, he was playing for the Cheetahs. It was the black guy with the blonde hair. I always say, yeah, give the black guy the ball. He was the only black guy on the team, you know what I mean? Well, so I saw. So I always follow players. But the interesting thing is, when you do this team thing, all of a sudden you get invested in a team. And now if you think about that, what for? And now when you get this team, now all of a sudden now it's like the race that you in your race. You identify with your race all the time. Then they got you divided, no matter what happens, you gotta root for your team, eh? You can't, you know, otherwise you'll get decimated. You go at the war with somebody else. Oh man, these people, they kill people in Europe because these footballers and whatever, because of that stuff. So I think the whole team thing, how do you say, feeds into this whole mentality of that we are not one global family. We're just, you know, we're doing things that you're supposed to fight against somebody, which is not a good thing. So when I talk about, people talk about something like, say white supremacy, they say, well, how's that? And I say, well, look, It exists, and what happens, everything around you sort of feeds into that mentality of, you know, it's us against them. There's one thing against another. And so the supremacists look back and say, hey, look, they're fighting. Don't bother us, we're away from it. Doesn't matter. Hey, they kill each other, we don't care. Anyway, I'm going far afield on that. Anyway, my point really is, I'm a universal citizen. That's what it says on my thing. I'm a universalist. I think everybody should just be a universal, no matter what you are. You know, I'm in South Africa, I like some different. See my hand? That's the way it goes. It goes that way because this has been a dispatch from the Arts Director Emeritus. That would be me, T, from thePatterson, taking the train to Tibet, letting you know what I only suspect.